What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's Daniel here from the Geek Speak Nation channel, and I'm here to bring you my reaction to the final trailer for War for the Planet of the Apes. So, War for the Planet of the Apes is a film I'm really excited for. I really enjoyed Rise of the Planet of the Apes when they did that reboot, and then Dawn was phenomenal. A really, really great film. I think the director, Matt Reeves, I believe is his name, did a fantastic job with that sequel, and it's exciting to see him come back again and see what he's going to do with this, and excited for him to be doing the Batman movie with Ben Affleck if he doesn't drop out like everyone drops out, if anything DC related. But we're not here to talk about DC, we're here to talk about War for the Planet of the Apes. I believe there was I reacted to the first trailer that they released, that teaser trailer. I don't believe I saw the official trailer that was released about a month ago or so. So this is going to be my next look at War for the Planet of the Apes. And the number one thing I'm really hoping for to look out for in this trailer is honestly just some more looks at Woody Harrelson's character. It's not that I don't have faith in Woody Harrelson as an actor. I think he's phenomenal. I just want to know what drives his character and how his character is written and how he's going to be portrayed and what type of presence is he going to have on screen and in the universe that's been created, the Apes universe, I guess. That's really the main thing I'm going to be looking out for. Besides that, hope there's not too many spoiler or plot details that they're throwing in since this is the final trailer. I just hope they really focus on making this just as enticing as possible, but reveal as little as possible. So, with that being said, let's check out this trailer. And here we go. Okay, got it. Yeah. All right. 20th Century Fox. That mocap is amazing.
Who is child?
I don't know.
But she was you.
She has no one else.
Okay, so she's
we
not
are
related.
Not savages. Apes fight only to survive.
Bad human kill. Ape. All dead now, a long time. Long time.
Bad humans.
Soldier.
Years from now, your children will ask you, what did you do in the greatest war?
And you can tell them,
I fought to protect this world.
And the world for God and
Moses. We created this. Okay.
But now, we will bring an end to their kind.
Interesting to see the division
of peace. This is war. Apes together strong.
You are impressive. You're smart as hell. You're stronger than we are, but you're taking this all much too personally.
So emotional!
Okay.
I did not start this war.
Wow. So one of the things that stuck out to me the most about this trailer is definitely the division amongst the apes community. Seeing Caesar as someone who holds on to his connection with other people, other human beings that he's known since, you know, birth and all that stuff, and growing up with James Franco for quite some time. Being able to connect the two, it's really interesting in that perspective. Still seeing how the division only increased after the second film and him being betrayed by Koba, I'd like to say. It's I just woke up and I'm recording this. I can't remember the name of the villain off the top of my head. But yeah, with that being said, it's really interesting to see that perspective and what reasoning would give the other apes to side with the humans. Is it because they want to end the war and they think that Caesar is perpetuating it? Or do they just not care? Or are they underneath the control of the humans being forced to? But they seem very complicit, not very reluctant. So seeing the political dynamics of this is going to be really interesting. Another thing that really caught my eye was the intellectual growth of the apes. I know that ever since the first film, they're talking about they're only going to get smarter and smarter and being able to communicate, but just seeing them slowly morph into what we see in the original film is just kind of astounding to see these steps being taken towards, you know, seeing the planet, seeing the apes become the fully sentient, fully communicating society of beings that they are. I think that's going to be really interesting to see that progression and just see how that communication goes. And I never cease to be amazed by the mocap that goes on. I think what Andy Serkis does, along with the amazing the technical innovations that go along when it comes to the animations department and the visual effects department, these guys do such an incredible job, and they really need to be getting the credit they deserve for the work that they put in. I think the VFX department for these films are incredible, and they put in so much work, and it completely pays off, and you get completely immersed in an experience in a way you never thought you could, just because of how darn good it looks. With that being said, also, I want to bring up Woody Harrelson, and I think I'm really digging what they're throwing down for Woody Harrelson. I like that when you throw up that line about you taking it a little too personal, that he's a man who sees things for as means to an end, sort of. He sees the use and the value of what other people can offer, and he sees when something is detrimental, and he's just, you know what, it's either it's dead or it's not when it comes to other people and the mindset that this guy runs with. It's very militaristic, but at the same time, he's kind of like this unpredictable loose cannon almost when it comes to his decision making and his brutality. So being able to see all that come together is really interesting, and that they're going to be clashing a lot, I think, is a really interesting choice, because sometimes you'll kind of do like the Dark Knight approach where you might go like half of the film and you know the villain and you know the hero, but they won't meet up until like halfway through the film, and then they clash and then it ends. And then you might have instances, and it looks like we're gonna have instances like this, where the hero or our protagonist of the tale and the villain are just gonna continuously clash throughout the film, and the stakes are gonna get increasingly higher as events transpire. I dig that. I can work with that. And I think it'll be really, really interesting. I hope that it just doesn't get too caught up in spectacle. I mean, there's a lot of explosions, there's a lot of war going on, and yeah, I'm all for that. I'm all for this this grand scale assault, this really, really big apes style war film. I'm totally up for it. I just hope we don't lose that connection with our characters emotionally, and we are always invested in the core of who these characters are. That's something I do not want to lose in this, and I don't think we will, but you know, it's always good to be cautiously optimistic when it comes to things like this. So with that being said, guys, let me know what you think of this trailer in the comment sections down below. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Are you excited for War for the Planet of the Apes? Huh. Oh my god, an eyelash almost got in my eye. Woo! So as I was saying, guys, before I almost had that incident happen, let me know what you think about this trailer in the comment sections down below. And if you like my reaction and my review, go down there and hit that like button. And if you're new here, maybe subscribe. As always, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your time. I really do appreciate it. I've been Daniel, and don't forget to get geeky.